Hi, this is Integza, and the question this week is, what does a private jet, a Bugatti, perfume, and a spinning ball have in common? Well, the answer is pretty obvious. Cristiano Ronaldo uses all of them.
Oh, I'm Bernoulli's principal.
Madness. This is Integza!
Bernoulli's principle states that an increase in speed of an incompressible fluid occurs simultaneously with a decrease in pressure. Decrease in pressure. But why? Well, let's start by the equation. Bernoulli's equation states the conservation of energy of a fluid in different states of pressure, velocity, and height. In this equation, we have three kinds of energy. Pressure energy, for example, I can store energy in this syringe by decompressing the air in it. We also have potential energy and kinetic energy. Look at this girl trying to swing to the water. Up there, she has a lot of potential energy. And basically this means she has a lot of distance to be accelerated by gravity. And accelerated she is, turning all that potential into kinetic energy. Now you're thinking, but this is not energy, this is just some girl falling. I will stop you right there. If we use the contraction to catch the girl, linked to an electrical alternator, we could generate power. Unfortunately, industry is not very interested in girl falling power. They prefer to use solar energy. So, the equation tells us that the summation of these three kinds of energy, in different states, must remain equal. That's why when the speed or kinetic energy goes up in one state, the pressure must decrease to compensate. This makes sense, mathematically. But physically, what happens? First, we will try to understand why the fluid speeds up just by going to a tube with smaller diameter. If we divide the fluid in columns of 4 fluid units, we can see the piston pushes a column through the marker in about 1 second. This is the key here. The fluid is being forced forward, so it has to keep this rate of 4 units per second. In the small diameter tube, we can't fit 4 units per column. So for the rate to continue the same, the units must go faster. That's why with different diameters, we have different velocity. But we still don't know why the pressure decreases. Before that, do you know what an incompressible fluid is? A fluid can be a gas or a liquid. They both flow. And can be compressible, what means they deform under pressure, or incompressible. Incompressible! Sorry about that. What means they don't deform? Unless you have the hole giving you a hand. In this case, the fluid will solidificate. It turns into ice. Actually, we can see how much pressure is needed to transform water into ice. I have it right here in my computer. We don't need to see that right now. The fluid's decrease in pressure is connected to the fluid's velocity by Newton's second law and momentum. If in this state the fluid has a velocity, and in the second state has a higher velocity, somewhere around here there's an acceleration. This acceleration creates tension in the fluid, what generates low pressure in the pipe. It's just like in a spring. Constant velocity, and you don't see much. But when you accelerate, you create a tension in the spring. Another cause to the fluid's low pressure in the smaller pipe is momentum. You accelerate the car towards the curve. You might turn the steering wheel exactly in the corner, but the car will not turn right away. Because it has momentum in this direction, it has the tendency to maintain itself in the same path at the same velocity, so the car doesn't follow the path we wanted. In the case of the fluid, we also have momentum. But because the fluid is incompressible, it cannot follow that path. Instead, tension is created in that spot, what also tends to push everything to it and generates low pressure. Please tell me that you now understand the Bernoulli's principle. Because if you don't, I dishonored myself and must perform the seppuku.
Sayonara, Bernoulli-chan! Oh!